We're going to begin a study on the Ten Commandments. So you may be asking yourself, why would we need to study the Ten Commandments? And I think in today's world, with so many people having so many different opinions as to what is right and what is wrong, I feel it's necessary that we go back and we look and see what God actually talked about in Exodus chapter 20. But before we get to that, I want us to look at 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21. That's 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21, and it says this: He made the one who did not know sin to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. And I want us to think about that even as we look at the Ten Commandments. Nothing that we can do in our deeds, actions, anything that we can do can make us righteous and being able to present ourselves to God. It is only through the work of Jesus Christ on the cross and God's grace and mercy that we become the righteousness of God. As we begin our study, I want us to look into Exodus chapter 20. That's where the Ten Commandments are found. But today we're only going to deal with verse 2. So I want us to look at that, Exodus chapter 20, verse 2, and it says, I am the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the place of slavery. I want us to take that word slavery right there, and I want us to really take a look at it in terms of the Bible and in terms of sin. If you were to look up what the word slavery means, it says a person who is the legal property. I want to pay attention to that word legal. The legal property of another and is forced to obey them. Before we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior and accept what He did on the cross for our sin, we are property of the law and property of the devil because of the law. So we are slaves to the law, which is the Ten Commandments, until we apply the blood of Jesus to that law. So we're going to take a look at the Ten Commandments as being the law of God. And until we accept Jesus Christ as our Savior, we are bound to the law. So therefore, we are in slavery to the law because of what the Bible says. In John chapter 8, verse 34, Jesus says this, Truly I tell you, everyone who commits a sin is a slave to sin. So everyone that goes against the teachings of the Bible, against the Ten Commandments as being the law of God, is a slave to sin. Now, I know you can find a lot of people that may tell you that this is okay, and this is okay, and this is okay, and they may have a whole lot of doctrines and PhDs in theology and all of this stuff stuck behind their name. But whatever they tell you, if it goes against the Word of God, then they are false teachers. So I want us to look at this in context of 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 19. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 19. And Peter is talking about false teachers, and he says this, They promise you freedom, but they themselves are slaves of corruption, since people are enslaved to whatever defeats them. So they are indeed slaves as well, because they are false teachers. They're not teaching what is in the Bibles, and they are slaves to sin themselves. They promise you freedom. They promise you everything is going to be okay, that the Bible is outdated, or the Bible is not the true Word of God, or it was written by a bunch of white men, or whatever you want to, whatever they, today, whatever they're peddling. They tell you it's okay. But that is a lie, and Satan has confused them, and you can be confused by them as well. If it is against the Bible, against the Word of God, then it is false. It is not true. Before we end our time today, I want us to look at one more passage of Scripture, and it is John chapter 1, verses 12 through 13. John chapter 1, verse 12 through 13, and it says this, But to all who did receive Him, He gave them the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not of natural descent or of the will of the flesh or the will of man, but of God. So I want us to break that verse down for just a minute, and I want us to look at it. It is not by the will of the flesh. That means anything that we can do, anything that we can bring, any of our deeds, actions, how good we are, has nothing to do with that. Not of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, and I believe that is generational, not because our fathers and our mothers were Christian that can be passed down, not because they were good or they want it. It cannot be of the will of man. It has to be from the will of God. So God has decreed that we have the right, if we believe and accept Jesus Christ, we have the right to become children of God. So that is believing that Jesus Christ died upon a cross for our sin, that he took our death that we have in the law, and he nailed it to a cross so that all of our sins are covered. That is part of the believing and then receiving his mercy and his grace. So it's not anything that we do. It is only through our accepting what he did on the cross and then us believing and us receiving his grace and his mercy. So at the very end, I want us to pray just a sinner's prayer. If this is the first time you've ever given your heart to God, I thank you, and just, you know, get you a Bible and study the Bible. If not, I think we can all at times reiterate what we did at our very beginning. So let us pray. Jesus, I am a sinner. I have sinned against you, and I acknowledge in my heart and in my mind and in my soul that I am not worthy of your mercy, but I confess to you that you died in my place. You took my sin to the cross and died for me. In my heart, in my mind, in my soul, I ask you to forgive me of my transgressions. I ask you to take control of my life. Give me a new heart, one that is responsive to your word. I receive now your grace and your mercy, and I am a changed person in Jesus Christ. I am no longer dead in sin, but I am alive in Christ. Amen.